When it comes to managing melasma, sunscreen is a crucial treatment step and preventative step. In this video, I'm going to apply and talk about three untinted sunscreens. All are 100% mineral sunscreens with active ingredients of zinc oxide and titanium dioxide, which provide the benefit of low risk of irritation. They are fragrance-free, all benefits for managing melasma, and the primary one being protection against the full spectrum of ultraviolet radiation to minimize the number one trigger for melasma. I will also include sunscreen tips throughout. Please keep watching. Welcome to Invest in Your Face, a channel dedicated to topics related to melasma. Hi, I'm Amy. I have melasma. And if you're interested in topics to help manage your melasma, please subscribe, hit that notification bell, and check out some of my previous videos. I want to send a quick thank you out to all my subscribers. I'm going to start off today by applying this non-tinted sunscreen by Suntique. It's called I'm Pure Perfect Cica, and Cica is short for Centella Asiatica. This mineral sunscreen contains Centella Asiatica extract, which has been shown to have many skin benefits, including helping to prevent UV-induced hyperpigmentation. It is made in Korea. It is SPF 50 with PA 4 pluses. And of the three I'm going to show you, this one has been my recent absolute favorite. Now, I've talked about the great beauty buys available at Costco in a previous video. And Costco is where I found this one. It is also available from Soko Glam, and I'll put links below for all the sunscreens. But when any item is available from Costco, that is the way I go. For not only a great value, because think about all the money that we spent on sunscreen, but also for their liberal return policy. If it doesn't work out for any reason, you can return it. So my first tip of this video is to check out Costco online for this sunscreen if you are a member. According to the FDA, the dermatologically recommended dose of sunscreen is 2 milligrams per square centimeter of skin. I don't know about you, but I'm not up for doing the math to figure out the surface area of my face and neck. And if you look it up, there is conflicting information about how much is enough, a quarter teaspoon, a half teaspoon, even a full teaspoon. So in general, a half teaspoon is an adequate amount to achieve the stated SPF coverage of most sunscreens for face, ears, and neck. So basically, my tip is to apply generously. And when it comes to my face, I am applying sunscreen all over, but for sure, generously to the sides of my face and upper lip area where I have melasma. I'm so happy with this sunscreen. This goes on smoothly. It feels more like a moisturizing lotion. It has a light whipped texture. It blends in quickly and easily. There is nothing thick or chalky about this sunscreen, which can be an issue with many zinc oxide and titanium dioxide options. Now, if you do not like the shininess of some mineral sunscreens, you will want to try this one, which leaves more of a matte finish, but not in a dry, cakey kind of way. My skin feels hydrated. It's not sticky. I like the finish, and I do not think the white cast is bad at all on my skin tone, as you can see. And I have put many mineral sunscreens to the test for a white cast, and today's recommendations all pass. If you prefer a little shine or glowiness, I like to look at it as a glow, of some sunscreens, which I do sometimes depending on my mood and the look I'm going for that day, then I recommend giving this next one a try. I originally came across this one when I was searching for a baby sunscreen formula for my husband's ultra-sensitive skin. Now, I tend to lean towards skincare formulations for sensitive skin anyway, because even though melasma is not indicative of having sensitive skin, melasma is triggered by skin irritation and inflammation. Another tip, I recommend anyone who has very sensitive skin to sunscreens to choose a mineral sunscreen formulated for babies. This is well stocked in my house, and I just learned that it is now available at Target. And it is Mineral Sunscreen SPF 50 by Pipette. And Pipette offers products for the whole family that are gentle, free from skin irritating ingredients, that are environmentally friendly and cruelty free. This texture is much like the Suntique and also blends in like a moisturizing lotion. A tip for applying any sunscreen evenly is a common dot method so that you ensure an even layer and don't miss any areas. I definitely focus on the areas of my melasma, especially when I reapply. And speaking of reapplying, it's a tip worth repeating, as all of you know, when managing melasma, reapply every couple of hours during daylight and more often if you get wet, sweat, or are in direct sunlight. Plus, the benefits of reapplying sunscreen go well beyond managing melasma when you consider the benefits of reducing the risks of skin cancer, protecting against premature aging, and maintaining overall healthy skin. And remember, mineral sunscreens protect the skin by physically screening the sun's rays, which means it's effective as soon as it's applied. This sunscreen blends in beautifully. I don't feel like I even have sunscreen on. This finishes with a little glow, as I mentioned. It is not tacky on the skin. It makes my skin feel soft but not greasy, and it even feels smooth on my lips. Ever notice how some sunscreens feel a little gritty and it's noticeable on the lips? Fortunately, not with any of the ones I'm sharing today. The last one I'm going to show you is called Green Mild Up Sun Plus by Dr. G. It is made in Korea. It is SPF 50 and PA 4 pluses. And I want to point out some additional ingredients in this one. Ceramides to help the skin barrier and retain moisture, vitamin E and centella asiatica for antioxidant properties. And I mentioned before the benefit of Cica, the UV induced hyperpigmentation. But one ingredient that caught my eye and I want to mention is Pinus pinister, also known as pycnogenol, which is maritime pine bark extract. Now, I will include a link to this video where I talk about this as an oral supplement and how studies have shown its benefits in treating melasma. Please check out that video. So I'm going to show my application. Another tip here is to shake the bottle or tube before applying it to blend and evenly distribute the ingredients. Now, this sunscreen has a thinner texture than the others, but it blends in easily. The finish is smooth with a slight shine, and I don't think the white cast is bad with this one, but any note of white cast is easily gone when followed up with a tinted mineral powder, CC cream, foundation, or concealer, either all over or just on the areas of melasma. This is the sunscreen I wore under the CC cream in a recent video where I talk about a great CC cream by Supergoop, which leads me to one of my final tips of the video. If you are wearing a non-tinted sunscreen, following it up with a tinted product will provide added protection for your melasma because of the protection against visible light that you get with iron oxide, which is what makes the product have that tinted color. This is the sunscreen I'm currently wearing under my foundation now. And I will wrap this up with the biggest tip, and that is the best sunscreen for you is the one you like, because that's the one you're more likely to use. The important thing is to find a good broad spectrum high SPF sunscreen that works well with your skin, that you like, fits your budget, and that you apply and reapply. This is the most beneficial step to help manage your melasma. I hope this video has been informative and has helped you to find new sunscreens to try. If so, please hit the like button. It helps to grow my channel. Share it with anyone who may benefit, and I will see you in my next video. Wishing you all good health, and thank you for taking the time to invest in your face. Bye.